are we, by saying that X percent has, through wireless technologies, the ability of these cities and the work, does that qualify as meeting the statutory speed goals? And I read this last sentence to say that we still have to talk about it in legal analysis.
The statute says 10 and 5, it doesn't say 10 and 5 wireless.
Right.
It doesn't say 10 and 5 wireline, it doesn't say 10 and 5 fixed wireless or cable. It says 10 and 5. And I don't think when the original task force was contemplating this language, my interpretation of their work would be that they weren't contemplating any single technology or any single entity being obligated to build, have high-speed service available everywhere. They were talking about, you know, the industry, the state, whoever. They were talking about service being available everywhere. So here it might be this technology, here it might be a different technology, but it was the state as a whole.
Andy's right. The thing we were talking about in wireless, the real player in wireless at that time was fixed wireless, like what Dan's doing. And mobile wireless was in such infancy that it really didn't, hit the radar screen. I think we should put that sentence in somewhere else as things to do, future work.
Yeah, or does this fit up in the, if we just talked about the changing landscape, does something like this fit there? Because it is, as
we've added, we're keeping a running list of items that are going to be our action discussions for 2015. Obviously, we've got unresolved discussions that need to happen here, so we'll add that. But part of that as well is, we don't have time to take a deep dive into this today, but because we operationally have to struggle with the lack of clarity on this, we have adopted the same thinking as the federal government in that affordability is a component of the definition of access. And so to this point, the idea that a mobile service with data caps does not, due to affordability reasons, does not meet the intent of the legislation for a home's sole internet access or a business internet access. And so again, I'm not putting words into the task force's mouth, but I will, because we've had to deal with this issue from an operational standpoint, that is a lens through which we've been looking at the issue. And so it would serve everyone well if the task force does at some point get more clarity.
I think that's kind of a bit what we're all kind of getting to here, and I think the report can say the state is meeting some goals with the service through wireless in terms of availability, and then address that since 2010 there's an affordability piece that impacts whether people adopt technology. It's available at certain times, and that doesn't cast, I don't think, a negative light on anyone. It just, like I was saying earlier, it just creates the way.
That's well said. The extent that you adopt technology, I have a wired connection, I have this thing. People have different ways of connecting based on what their needs are. But as a provider, I can tell you, we see, customers choosing wireless as their solution. So it's really difficult for me to sit in the room and hear the listeners debate, because I know I'm losing customers to call. It's customers are making that choice, whether they're data caps or not, they're making that choice.
Well, and the preferred method for even the, I would say, those individuals on any type of a government assistance program is not to be tethered to their home for phone service. It's prepaid, like a track phone type thing or anything like that. I mean, it raises my attention when the Center for Disease Control tracks these things, and they've been doing that for a number of years. And that adoption